welcome to the Preacher's Bees. As you can see, the bees are flying pretty good today. It's been a while since I made a video, just a bunch of stuff going on. But today I thought I better get into this hive here. If you look at the bottom of it, it's really bearding up. It's the only one in my apiary. This is one of my breeder queens. I don't want her swarming. So I want to get in here, make sure they have enough room, because they're either hot or overcrowded. So I want to check that out. Again, pardon the vehicles as they go by. We're going to get in here and see what's going on and make sure this hive's okay. But stick around. I'm glad you're back. Sure the queen's not up here. Full of bees. That may be the problem. This frame is full of nectar. Not capping it yet, but it is full of nectar. Heavy. It is heavy. Got a little bit of cap there on the corner. I'm going to set this out. Don't see any brood on this frame. Gotta watch your hand. Queen's got this laid up. Nice white larva down inside there. Oh yeah, this side's laid up. She's doing a good job. She's doing a good job. Ringed with honey and nectar. Box on here. She is definitely booming. Oops, set that in too close. Pull it over here to the edge. Check this one. I gotta make sure there's no swarm cells in here. Not making preparation. This is upside down, but as you can see, that is full sheet of brood. That's one of my breeder queens. That's a Caucasian or a Carnolian, the Carnies. And then this side is the same. They're Carnies, and trying to get this bloodline started here in my apiary. And it's looking good. She is doing really great. Next frame is one that they built out. Be with your bees, the better it is for you in working your bees, because if your bees associate your disruptions with chaos, they can get aggressive towards you as you're beekeeping, because they know every time you get into the box, it's going to be a chaotic situation. So you want to keep crushing the bees to a very again, I got to deal with vehicles, but you want to keep the crushing of bees as minimal as possible. Like these bees, they seem to be a little bit more forgiving as far as the speed at which you can go through them. This is solid nectar. There's a small patch in the center there. When I say small, I'm talking tiny. Right there. It's a polished cell that she has not laid in. Over and see if I can show you that. I don't know if they'll come out in the camera. If you look down in those cells, you will see that there are eggs in there. I hope you can see them. You can see her. There's my queen. I'm looking in the camera. Yep, there you can see her. She's a really pretty girl. These carnelians are very dark. Very dark. She is doing good. Now, she's on an outside frame, so I gotta be very careful putting this back in. Up where she needs to be. Oops. I also see something here that I don't want. If they build comb on the edge and she's on this outside frame, you can literally crush your queen putting her back in. See that? That's fur comb on the box. You want to get rid of that before you try and put it back in. Oop, now she's coming around the other side. Come on, girl. Where'd you go? This in. I certainly don't want to have dropped my queen. Oh, there she is. She is on the bottom. I got to get her on the comb. breath to blow on her just a little bit. That'll push her and the bees. To the comb. Okay. She's on the inside, so I can put her back gently. Too many bees in here. I don't think there's such a thing as too many bees. Bee bread and larva, or capped brood. It's kind of amazing if you look at that. All throughout there, wherever there's a hole, it's actually not a hole, it's all bee bread. The whole way up into here, down through here. Now there it's open a little bit, but there's nectar in there also. But the bees will collect that and move it up. And this side is another good frame of brood. Pull it back and forth to get it down, or you'll smash bees. If you don't want to smash bees, that really upsets them. Yeah, she's got brood all through this bottom. She is really doing good. Yeah, she's got this laid up. There's larvae all the way out. No queen cells. I'm going to shake this one off just to make sure there's a lot of bees in there. Wow, that is completely laid out. Eggs, larva, the whole way out. This side as well. This queen is just super awesome. Okay. I'm going to put this all back together, and I'll be right back with you. Okay, this box is gonna need some space. This late in the game, we are now, it's the 2nd of July, so I am going to put on another deep box for now, and I'm not gonna bring you along for that. That's just a matter of pulling that one frame, pulling up. There's one frame of brood in here, which I'll let in this box, but I'm going to pull up two of those frames that had honey on them into that top box and then drop two drawn comb down into that bottom box. down into this box. That way the queen will have a place to lay some more eggs and continue going throughout the summer here. And then they'll move all their honey up into this top box, which will get them ready for winter, because they'll fill that top box with honey, and that's a good thing. Hey, this is the Preacher's Bees. It's good to have you along with me. Be blessed and be a blessing. Bye now.